Hello dear friends, welcome to the lecture of differential calculus. In this lecture we shall study partial differentiation, definition and some simple examples. Earlier in 11th and 12th class we have studied differentiation, that is total differentiation, and what is the difference between the earlier differentiation, which is total differentiation, and partial differentiation, that we shall see, and why partial derivatives occur, or why there is a need to consider partial differentiation. For total differential, we have a function, say y is a function of x, and that we denote as y is equal to f of x. And we, now this is a function of single variable, and here we differentiate y with respect to x. Derivative measures the rate of change of one variable with respect to the other variable. So y is dependent variable and x is independent variable. We say y is a function of x. If there is change in x, there will be corresponding change in y, and that changes are related changes are measured in derivatives, and we have limit as h tends to 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h. If this limit exists, then this is known as the derivative of y with respect to x. Then this is denoted, we have denoted this earlier by dy by dx. So what happens here is there is change in x, single variable, there is change in x, and this is the original value. So this is the difference in the values of f divided by difference in the values of x, that is x plus h minus x means h, and the ratio of this is taken, and its limit when h, this change in x is very small, is called the derivative of y with respect to x. So this is the usual definition of derivative we have studied earlier. Now suppose here it is a function of single variable, but there are many functions which are functions of multivariables, that are, that means function of more than one variable. For example, if I write z as function of x and y, then it is a function of two variable. So examples of multivariate function can be considered as production of a crop in a farm, or agriculture production of a crop is to be considered, then that depends on many factors, that is area of land, irrigation, fertilizer, etc. So that means production of a crop is a function of irrigation, land, then fertilizer, also weather, etc. It depends on many factors, and therefore it becomes a function of multivariable. And whenever such functions are there, then we have to consider change in the variables x or change in variable y, and that means we measure the rate of change of z either with respect to x or with respect to y. Then that derivative will be derivative with respect to one variable, that means the second variable is fixed. Now if you consider the production of a crop, then that the area of a land is increased, then there is increase in the production, and other variables kept as it is, that means the labor or fertilizer are being fixed, then one variable changes, there is change in the production or change in function. Such changes are to be considered as partial, because we are changing only one variable and other variable is to be treated as constant or as it is. So now if here z is function of x and y, now we can consider the change in the variable x, then that derivative of z will be partial derivative with respect to x, and here we will consider limit as h tends to 0. H is denoted as change of f of x plus h comma y, means we have changed x to x plus h, minus the original value is f of x comma y divided by h. And if this limit exists, then that limit is known as or is called the partial derivative of f with respect to x, or here it is also z is the same as f, z is equal to f, and that is a partial derivative of f with respect to x. This notation is also different. Here we now you can see the changes in this first derivative and the second derivative. Here it is function of single variable, one variable, and here it is function of two variables, more than one, maybe two variable, 3, 4 n variables, two variables. And then we have considered y as constant, there is no change in y. Function changes its value from f of x comma y to f of x plus h comma y, and that difference in the values of f is taken at the numerator, divided by difference in the value of x, x plus h minus x, that is h, is taken at the denominator, and its limit as h tends to 0 is the partial derivative of f with respect to x. So that is the meaning of partial derivative. This is the symbol of partial derivative. See, squirrel, a rounded D. Instead of D, it is rounded D. This symbol is some people call it del, but we shall say it as deba. Deba f by deba, or do may also be said. So do f, I shall say it as do. Do f by do x. Or partial f, partial derivative of f with respect to x. It may be said like this: partial derivative of f with respect to x, or del f by del x, or do f by do x. So these, this is the notation of partial derivative. And here we will write as definition first. Let z is equal to f of x comma y be a function of x and y, then limit as h tends to 0 f of x plus h comma y minus f of x comma y divided by h. So if this limit exists, this limit must exist, then and only then the derivative will exist. If the limit does not exist, then the derivative will not exist. If it exists, it is called the partial derivative. Partial derivative of f with respect to x. And is denoted by do f by do x or f suffix x. This is the notation to denote the partial derivative, do f by do x or f suffix x. And thus do f by do x, partial derivative of f with respect to x, or f suffix x, is limit h tends to 0 f of x plus h comma y minus f of x comma y divided by h. This is the definition of partial derivative of f with respect to x. Similarly, we can define partial derivative of f with respect to y, and that will be, see, in the same way we have similarly partial derivative of f with respect to y is dou f by dou y, and that is f suffix y. What will happen here? Here we are taking the partial derivative with respect to y, means there is changes in y, there will not be any change in x. So that is the important thing in partial differentiation. If we are taking the partial derivative with respect to one variable, then there will that will change. Remaining will be constant. So here x will remain constant, and thus it will be limit h tends to 0 f of x. There is no change. There will be change in y, that is f of x comma y plus h minus f of x comma y divided by h. This may be written as h or may be written as k, but we will use the same notation h. So you see here, this is dou f by dou x, partial derivative of f with respect to x. Here there is change, increment in x. It is the derivative with respect to x. Y is constant. And here this is partial derivative of f with respect to y, and there is increment in y or changes in y, and x is constant. So this is the partial derivative of f with respect to y. And now in particular, if you want to find the derivative of z or f at a point AB, so in particular partial derivative of f at a particular point, at a point A comma B. Now here we are considering two variables, x comma y, and a point will be, this will be in a plane, point will be A comma B. Partial derivative of f at point A comma B, at point is, it is denoted by with respect to x is dou f by dou x, partial derivative of f with respect to x at point AB, or this may also be written as fx at AB, and this is limit h tends to 0. So what will be here? This is at point AB. Instead of, that means the point in place of xy general point, the point is now AB, and here it is with respect to x. X coordinate is A, so therefore there will be increment in A plus h b as it is minus f of A comma B divided by h. So this will be the particular point derivative of partial derivative of f at a point with respect to x, or partial derivative with respect to x at point A comma B. Likewise, we can write the partial derivative of f at point AB with respect to y, and that will be dou f by dou y, and that is limit f of A will remain same, and there will be increment in B. So this is the definition of partial derivative. Now higher order partial derivatives we shall see. As like total derivatives, now there will be higher order partial derivatives. Total derivative we have denoted by dy by dx, d square y by dx square, etc. Higher order partial derivatives. Now here also we consider z is equal to f of xy, function of x and y. Z is dependent variable, x and y are independent variable. Z is a function of x and y. Then we assume the derivatives exist, that means limit exists. Then dou z by dou x, which is same as dou f by dou x. See, z is equal to f, that is a notation. So the y is equal to f of x, then we say dy by dx is f dash x. Derivative of f is derivative of y with respect to x. And here dou z by dou x is partial derivative of f with respect to x, or that is f suffix x. These are the notations. And with respect to y, partial derivative of z with respect to y, that is partial derivative of f with respect to y, or that is f suffix y, are partial derivatives of f partial derivatives of first order of f, or you can say first order partial derivatives. First order partial derivatives of f with respect to x and y, respectively. This is first order partial derivative of z or f with respect to x, and that is the second is first order partial derivative of f with respect to y. Now further, second order derivatives can also be defined as like second order total derivatives. Partial derivative of this partial derivative we shall consider again. Next. Dou by dou y of dou z by dou x, or you can say f here, dou f by dou x, it is the same, dou z by dou x, dou f by dou x is the same, and that we write as dou square f by dou y dou x. Or we can say first we shall take it is with respect to x only, partially differentiate this with respect to x again, and that will be dou by dou x. The operator of partial derivative with respect to x will be dou by dou x, and this will be dou x into dou x, that is dou x square. So that is partial derivative of f, second order partial derivative, or it may be denoted by fxx. And likewise, partial derivative with respect to y of partial derivative of f with respect to y. And this will be dou square f by dou y square, or that is f suffix yy. Or the next we can consider mixed derivative dou by dou x of dou f by dou y, and this will be dou square f by dou x dou y, or that can be written as f x y dou by dou y of dou f by dou x, that is dou square f by dou y dou x, or it may be written as f suffix yx. So these are all second order derivatives, and that means in all, if z is function of two variable x and y, then there will be four types of second order partial derivatives. So dou square f by dou x square, dou square f by dou y square, dou square f by dou x dou y, dou square f by dou y dou x are second order partial derivatives of f or z. And now we see that what is the difference in this. Here first f is differentiated partially with respect to y and then with respect to x, and here f first is differentiated partially with respect to x and then with respect to y, but in general these two are equal. So we write it as a remark, and in this way the higher order partial derivatives can be obtained, the cubic, that means third order partial derivative of f with respect to x will be dou cube f by dou x cube, and that can be denoted by f of suffix triple x, x x x and so on, so on. Nth order partial derivative can be taken. Now here we write a remark. In general, dou square f by dou x dou y is equal to dou square f by dou y dou x. In some cases, special cases, they may not be equal, but in general these derivatives are equal. That means it is immaterial if you first differentiate with respect to y, or then with respect to x, or first with respect to x and then with respect to y. Means these derivatives are equal in general, not always, but in general. So thus this is the definition, notation and higher order partial derivative notation also we have seen. Now we shall solve some problems on it. Now one thing is to be noted, how to differentiate. When we differentiate partially with respect to x, suppose it is a function of x and y, and when we differentiate it partially with respect to x, y is to be treated as constant. We have defined like that only. And when we differentiate partially with respect to y, then x is to be treated as constant. So, and further, all the rules and formulae of differentiation remains the same. So that means, so the formulae and rules of total differentiation are applicable for the partial differentiation. That is the derivative of sum, derivative of difference, then derivative of product, derivative of quotient, these rules. And also what is important is the chain rule. It remains the same for partial differentiation also. Only when we are differentiating with respect to one variable, treat all other variables as constant. That is the important difference in partial and total differentiation. Now some problems. First is, find first order partial derivative. First order partial derivatives of, first we can write z is equal to say e to the power ax into sine by. Second, z is equal to say tan inverse of, I shall write this as x square or x plus y. Or yes, so we shall solve this. Z is e power ax into sine by. Now first we are asked to find first order partial derivatives, means dou z by dou x, partial derivative of z with respect to x, differentiating z with respect to x partially, differentiating partially with respect to x. Hereafter we shall write it directly. And what is the notation? Rounded d dou z by dou x is equal to, when we differentiate partially with respect to x, we have to treat the remaining variable, that is y. This is the a and b are constant, x and y are variables, z is variable dependent, but independent are only to x and y. And we are differentiating partially with respect to x, means y is constant, this b is also constant, and therefore this entire term sine by becomes constant. And we write this term as it is, as constant, that is sine by. And we have to differentiate e to the power ax partially with respect to x, and we know the derivative of e power ax is e power ax into the derivative of a into x. A is constant, and therefore derivative of a into x is a. So this much is the partial derivative of z with respect to x. It is simple. We have used the chain rule. This is constant first written, and e power ax, derivative is e power ax into derivative of ax, that is a, by chain rule is also used. And differentiating z partially with respect to y. So what we shall get is partial derivative of z with respect to y. Now what happens? So we have to consider x as constant, means this first term is constant, and we have to write the derivative of sine by. So first term is constant, a term of x is constant. So that is only the important rule to be remembered for getting the partial differentiation. We are differentiating with respect to a variable partially, then treat all other variables constant. So e power ax is constant, derivative of cos sine is cos of by into derivative of by with respect to y, that is b. So this much is the partial derivative of z with respect to y, and thus we are asked to find only the first order derivatives. Now what about the second? Second is z is tan inverse of x plus y. So what will be the derivative of that? For second, z is tan inverse of x plus y, and therefore partial derivative of z with respect to x, I am writing now directly, partial derivative of z with respect to x is, what is the derivative of tan inverse? Earlier formula, the formula for differentiation remains the same for total or partial. Tan inverse x, we know the derivative of tan inverse x, total derivative, 1 divided by 1 plus x square, and therefore here derivative of tan inverse of x plus y will be 1 divided by 1 plus x plus y whole square. This is the function x plus y, inner function, and therefore it is 1 upon 1 plus x plus y whole square into, we have to use the chain rule, into the derivative of inner function, partial derivative with respect to x, into dou by dou x of x plus y. And what is the derivative of partial derivative of x? Here the derivative of sum is to be used, rule. Partial derivative of x is 1, partial derivative of y is 0, because y is to be treated as constant when we differentiate partially with respect to x, and thus this is actually 1. So 1 upon 1 plus x plus y whole square, or this is 1 plus 0, and that is only this quantity. Also, what will be dou z by dou y? Here also the outer function is tan inverse, its derivative remains the same in the same form, 1 over 1 plus x plus y whole square into partial derivative with respect to y of x plus y. What is the change here? Partial derivative of inner function with respect to x, here we are differentiating with partially with respect to y, and the tan inverse derivative remains in the same form, but we have to multiply it by the partial derivative of x plus y with respect to y. Again, the partial derivative of x is 1, not 1, it is constant, x is constant. When we differentiate partially with respect to y, it is 0, and partial derivative of y with respect to y is 1. So therefore, this is 1 upon 1 plus x plus y whole square in bracket, 0 plus 1. And in this case, these two first order derivatives are the same. Now we shall consider the second example as see second, if u is equal to sine inverse of x upon y, verify that dou 2u by dou y dou x is equal to dou 2u by dou x dou y. We have written as a remark, in general these are equal, and for this function we shall verify these two are equal. The function is sine inverse of x upon y. Likewise, we should have to use the rule and the formula for the derivative. Here first we consider u. The function may be denoted by u or z. U is equal to sin inverse of x upon y. Differentiate first with respect to x, then partial derivative of u with respect to x is equal to, using the first chain rule we have to use here, because it is a composite function, sin inverse outer function, x upon y is the inner function, and therefore we have to write first the derivative of the outer function, sin inverse. We know the derivative of sin inverse x is 1 over under root 1 minus x square, and therefore this becomes 1 over under root 1 minus, instead of x here is x upon y, so x upon y whole square into partial derivative of the inner function x upon y with respect to x, or that becomes now you see here we have to simplify it, and what will be the simplification? 1 minus x square upon y square. So 1 minus I shall subtract this or multiply the numerator and denominator by y square, then that becomes y square minus x square divided by root of y square will be at the denominator, and root of y square is y, and that will be at the numerator. You can verify this, it will be y square minus x square. And what is the derivative of partial derivative of x upon y with respect to x? 1 by y is constant, derivative of x is 1, so that is 1 upon y. Say this is algebraic simplification, you can verify it. And now y divides out, and that remains 1 over under root y square minus x square. I shall write that in power form, y square minus x square, and root means half power, but at that it is at the denominator, and therefore at the numerator power will be negative half, and that is dou u by dou x. Now we differentiate this partially with respect to y, because we want to get this term dou 2u by dou y dou x, and that will be. Now how to differentiate this dou u by dou x partially with respect to y? That is dou by dou y of dou u by dou x is equal to, and again this is partial derivative with respect to y. Use chain rule in derivative is important, because many functions are in composite function form, and therefore power outer function is power function, and we know derivative of x power n is n x power n minus 1. Same rule we have to first use, minus half, and in place of x it is function of x and y, that is y square minus x square raised to minus half minus 1, that is minus 3 by 2 into dou by dou y of inner function. What is inner function? Y square minus x square. Here we have used the chain rule, and now you see the first we shall keep as it is, and what is the derivative of this second term? Y square minus x square. Derivative of y square we know it is 2y, and this is to be treated as constant with respect to partial derivative of with respect to y, so that is minus half into y square minus x square to the power minus 3 by 2 in bracket 2y minus 0, and this half and 2 divides out, 2 divided by 2 is 1, and therefore what remains is minus y. I shall write first y square minus x square to the power minus 3 by 2. We shall suppose this equation as 1, this as 2, and what is this term? This term is dou square u by notation, dou square u by dou y dou x. Now thus we have obtained the left side. Now to find the right side, first here we have differentiated with respect to y, here we have differentiate first with respect to y, here it is differentiated with respect to x. Now this letter written differentiation occurs first, that is first with respect to y. Now differentiate 1 partially with respect to y, and that is dou u by dou y, And you see again this use the chain rule. Sine inverse derivative is 1 upon under root 1 minus x by y whole square into derivative with respect to y of x upon y. That is the change. Here it is with respect to x, here it is with respect to y. And what is the partial derivative of x upon y? Here this term again is y divided by under root of y square minus x square. And now the derivative with respect to y, x is treated as constant. So you may use quotient rule or you may use the reciprocal function. So if you use quotient rule, then the denominator is y square. The numerator is y term, that is denominator, into derivative of x, that is 0 because x is constant, minus x as it is, and derivative of y is 1 with respect to y. So this is by quotient rule. So we have written by quotient rule. And you see this will be dou u by dou y. Now that can be simplified. One term of this is 0 minus x upon y square. One term of y cancels. What remains is minus x upon y. That is dou u by dou y. Therefore, dou u by dou y is minus x upon y into, and this term is y square minus x square to the power negative half. Half power at denominator, at numerator it will be minus half. Thus we have obtained dou u by dou x. Now we shall to obtain this differentiate partially with respect to x. Differentiate this partially with respect to x. And we get dou by dou x of dou u by dou y, and this is partial derivative with respect to x. And when we differentiate partially with respect to x, outer derivative is now we are applying with respect to x, y is to be treated as constant. And you see the term of y is y at denominator and minus 1 is constant. So I shall write minus 1 by y constant. And the partial derivative of remaining, that is with respect to x, dou by dou x of x into y square minus x square to the power minus half. What I have done is the constant is written outside, and to obtain this derivative partially we have to use the product rule because it is a product, or that is now minus 1 upon y constant using the product rule. First function as it is, derivative of this, that is by power function and chain rule, minus half y square minus x square raised to minus half minus 1 minus 3 by 2 into derivative of inner function. And that is, you see, derivative of y square is 0, derivative of minus x square is minus 2x. So this much is the first term, plus now the derivative of the first function, that is x, derivative of x is 1, second as it is, that is y square minus x square raised to minus half. So this is by product rule. Product rule of derivative. Now you see further that can be simplified as, now what is the left side? You see the left side is dou by dou x of dou u by dou y, means that is dou 2 u by dou y dou x, and that is equal to, now from this you see this minus half into minus 2 becomes 1, and this x into x is x square, and from these two the minimum power is minus 3 by 2, that we should take common. So I shall write minus 1 by y, and I shall take y square minus x square raised to minus 3 by 2 common from these two terms. Minimum power, minus 3 by 2 is less than minus half, and therefore minimum power is taken common. What remains from the first term, this is taken common, x into x, half and minus half and minus 2 cancels, x into x, that is x square, And if we take this common term from this, what remains inside the bracket is y square minus x square. You can verify that is 1. 1 minus 3 by 2 is minus half. The power is the same. Minus 3 by 2 plus 1, that is minus half. You can verify this. And you see what is the bracket. X square cancels this minus x square and x square becomes 0. Y square remains. Y square divided by y is y at numerator and there is minus sign. That is minus y, y square minus x square to the power 3 by 2. And this is third. So what is the left side is dou 2 u by dou y dou x. And you see from second and third, these two are equal. Their right sides are equal means these values are equal and hence the verification. Hence, from 2 and 3, dou 2 u by dou y dou x is equal to dou 2 u by dou x dou y. And this completes the solution. So in general, these derivatives are equal. Now, you should solve some problems of this type at home. So I shall give you these problems. Problems for practice. Now these are some problems I have written for you to solve. First is find the first order derivatives of z e to the power x power y. And the answers I have written. So only what you have to remember is when we differentiate partially with respect to x, treat y as constant. Accordingly, the form of the function or the nature of the function changes. And we have to use the respective formula and also the rule of differentiation. And so answers I have written here. So think about it and solve it first and check the answer. The next is z is equal to log of x square plus y square. This also external function, chain rule also you have to use. External function is log. We know derivative of log x is 1 upon x. And the second problem is if u is log of x square plus y square plus z square, then prove this result. Now you remember that here u is function of x, y and z, three variables. And therefore there will be the partial derivative of u with respect to x, y and also z. When we differentiate partially with respect to x, treat y and z as constant. And likewise, so first you get this term or you may get this term first. So instead of this one, dou x, dou y. Anyway, you can obtain the values of these three terms. So these second order partial derivatives of u with respect to differentiate this with respect to y first, then with respect to x, get that term. Differentiate this with respect to x first, that is obtained earlier, then differentiate it with respect to z, and differentiate with respect to z first, then with respect to y, and show these are all equal. It is not difficult. You should try yourself. So this is about the definition of partial derivative and some problems on it. Remaining part we will continue next time. Thank you.